جايين من كل مكان للصورة زينة البلدان زورون رجع فرحان
شو تمرين في ربوتاي Vous venez pas méchant of Hashem de Parasha of Nasso. We read that we know that this parasha is the longest parasha of all the parashiyot, and there is something special in this parasha that what it makes it longer because there were the korbanot that the Bnei Israel that each prince of Shevet he did his own sacrifice. And Hashem, he wanted to show the Bnei Israel how much each Shevet, each tribe is value in his eyes. Because we may think it's Yehuda or Levi or Issachar, no, or Yosef, no. Hashem wanted to show that all the tribe, all of Israel, each tribe are the value in his eyes. But what is very important is the Shevet Shimon, Shlumiel ben Tzuri Shaddai. This man was a very, very old man. And this man, he, according to Hachamim, he is Zimri. He is the one who went out with the Goya. And the question is, how? Why HaKadosh Baruch Hu let that man? Okay, he was a big tzaddik. But at that time he was a big tzaddik. But can you imagine what he did? He went, because of him, more than 20,000 Jews, they were killed. He went with a Goya. And he took the Goya. Do you know, he was a very old man. There is, maybe he was over 400 years old. Or there is some who said he was 270 years old. A very old man. And he was a prince. He was among those who inaugurated the Beit HaMikdash. He was a big tzaddik. We don't understand how we did the Avera with a Goya. And he said to Moshe Rabbeinu, this woman, she's permitted to me or not? And Moshe Rabbeinu said, no. So he told him, if she's not permitted to me because she's Midianite, who give you permission to marry Tzipora? One comparison. You compare Tzipora with that Goya. Tzipora, she was a big tzaddiket. She was the wife of Moshe Rabbeinu. She saved Moshe Rabbeinu. She did the Brit Milah to her son. Yeah. What comparison between this Goya and the Tzipora? So my question is, why did Hashem let this man to be among the prince? Why? What happened? Why? What it is the message that we have to learn from this parasha? But there you know that when the Am Israel they went from Egypt to go to receive the Torah, they were preparing themselves to receive the Torah, and because they did not study Torah be'amal with a big effort, so Amalek came. And you know all the story what happened with Amalek. And the Torah was to teach us that the only way that the Torah can protect you and can protect against your etzara when there is Amal. Amal, effort. You know, unfortunately, we do a lot of effort for everything. And Hashem wants that the same way that we do effort for everything, we should do an effort for him. A lot of times we are tired all week. All week we are tired. And Sunday morning, we think, well, let's sleep a little bit more. Again, tomorrow I have to wake up at 6 o'clock. Yeah, but Hashem is a jealous. Hashem doesn't like when you do effort for business, you do effort to buy a nice house, you do effort to buy a nice car, you do effort to give to your wife a nice present, you do effort to take the best holiday. And for him, the one who gives you everything, you don't do an effort for him. No Torah, no tefillah. Hashem, he doesn't like it. He's a little bit jealous of it. You know, there was a big rabbi this morning I was reading, a big, big tzaddik. The day that he said that when the Bnei Israel heard the voice of Hashem, Anuchi Hashem Elokecha, Kadosh Baruch Hu give them the Torah, then after they received the Torah, they went to Moshe Rabbeinu and told him, Moshe, Moshe, please talk to us, you. Don't let Hashem talk to us because we might die. So this rabbi, a big tzaddik, he asked a beautiful question. He said, I don't understand. Those people, they don't want to listen to the voice of Hashem. What a big opportunity they had now to listen to the voice of Hashem. And they said to Moshe Rabbeinu, we prefer that you talk to us, you, not Hashem. How is it possible not to listen? I prefer to listen to the voice, to see the Torah of Hashem than from a rabbi. So why they said, and Moshe and even Hashem, he agreed with them. What exactly what they meant? And this big rabbi, he said something incredible. He said, Moshe, maybe we're not enough prepared to listen to the voice of Hashem. Maybe, as we shall, if we die, we will not do Torah mitzvot. So we prefer that we learn from you. But maybe we are not enough tzaddikim to have the zichut to listen to the voice of Hashem. Not Chas v'Shalom, they didn't want to listen to the voice of Hashem, only because they thought they are not well prepared. And Hashem agreed with them. He says, you're right. So you see, my friend, how much the Torah is so important to learn the Torah. Bemet, it's so important because, as always, I repeat, the Torah is the only thing after 120 years we can find. Nothing else we will find. When the Bnei Israel, they arrived to the sea and they had a problem, what are they going to do? Hashem said to Moshe, tell them, go straight. But it was a problem to go straight. Where? There is the sea. I mean, if like I tell to somebody the way to go, it's through here. But there is a wall. How can I go through this wall? The answer is, if Hashem told you, go through the wall, so you do it. You must have emuna. If Hashem tells you, because Hashem, if he tells you, that means Hashem, he has a way how to through. Why? We did not have a lot of problems in our lives. And Baruch Hashem, Hashem, and we thought there was no solution. You know, 2 days ago, on Friday, I received a phone call from William Marciano, as you know him, all of you know him. 2 weeks ago, we went to see somebody in Paris that is very, very, very ill, and the doctors did not give him a chance to live. They did not give him a chance. He just got married 6 months ago, and his wife, she is pregnant. And I was very, very, very upset about him. And suddenly he told me, since 2 or 3 months, there is more than 200 young boys that destroy the Torah every day for his refuah. I said, so because of you, 200 people study Torah. He said, not because of me. It's a way to pray to Hashem for my health. So I told him, enough what those people are doing for you, that Hashem will send you a refuah shelema. Can you imagine? Because of you, there is 200 people who study Torah. You are the cause. So I'm sure that HaKadosh Baruch Hu will do with you a big, bigness. But his father told me, but the doctor said, there is no way to do, there is nothing to do. I said, yes, the doctor, that is the medicine, but there is Hashem, the Torah, we call the Torah Terufa. Torah is as well a medicine. A Torah Magina Umatzuli, the Torah protect. We know that. So I'm sure, with this mitzvah that indirectly you cause that people study Torah because of you, that enough that Hashem will give you a refuah. And when he started, before he started to do an aggressive shimo, chemo. The doctors decided to test, to do all kind of exams before they decide what exactly to give him, just to relieve his sufferance. And they did not find nothing. That's what happened last week. They did not find nothing. And William Arsene is telling Rabbi David, the other family are shocked. They don't understand. So I told them, there is nothing to understand. This is the koach of the Torah. This is the koach of the Torah. People don't know, people don't realize what they are missing. Unfortunately, people think, waste of time. They don't understand. The Gemara said, if the nations, they know that with the zichut of the Torah that the Jewish people are studying, and bizchut the tefillot that they pray, they have prosperity. You know what they will do? The nations, they will come to wake up us in the morning. Hey, Moshe, David, wake up and go study Torah, go to pray. But unfortunately, they don't know. No one knows. And this is the surprise. This is the Rabotai, the big surprise. So when Am Israel, they arrived to the sea, they did not know what to do. Hashem said, go straight. But there is a wall. There is the sea. They don't know how to swim. There is children. What can they do? Well, that's what they did. They started, Nachshon Be'Ami Nadav started to go ahead. And then the rest of the Jews started to follow him, and the miracle happened. Rabotai, this is a message for generations to Am Israel. When we follow the step of Hashem, Kadosh Baruch Hu help. When you see yourself, there is no way out from your problems, have a bitachon Kadosh Baruch Hu. And the only way is Torah, mitzvot, ma'asim tovim. There was the Orach Chaim HaKadosh, he asked a beautiful question. He said, I don't understand. When Rabbi Pinchas ben Yair, he wanted to cross the river, he talked to the river, river, I want to cross, I want to pass. And there was no answer. And then Rabbi Pinchas ben Yair, he said, river, if you don't split, you don't let me cross, I will dry you. There'll be no water coming to this river. There'll be no river anymore. And the river split. And Rabbi Pinchas ben Yair passed, and he list past other people behind him. So the Chaim HaKadosh said, I don't understand. Is the student he's more than the rabbi? Moshe Rabbeinu, he couldn't, Moshe, that he was a big tzaddik. We call him Moshe Rabbeinu. He couldn't do Kriat Yam Suf. And Rabbi Pinchas ben Yair, he did it. And the Orach Chaim HaKadosh, he gave a beautiful answer. He said there is a difference between before Matan Torah and after Matan Torah. Before Matan Torah, the nature, the Teva, it will not change. Hashem created a teva. The teva is things are natural. They have to remain right natural. So Moshe Rabbeinu couldn't split the sea because they had no the koach. Like today the tzaddikim. Today the tzaddikim, they have the koach, the power to change everything. If Hashem said this man is going to die, the tzaddik will say, no, he will not die. So he will not die. Hashem will say, this man will have no children. So the tzaddik, he said, no, he will have children. Hashem has no option to listen to the tzaddik. Why? With the zikud of the Torah. Because when Hashem, he see the tzaddik studying Torah, so this is the condition. When you study Torah, HaKadosh could change everything for you. So now we understand why that was the message. That was the message to the Bnei Israel. Without Torah, the nature cannot change. But at the time of Rabbi Pinchas ben Yair, he had already the zechut of the Torah. With the zechut of the Torah, he can't talk to the river and split the river and to tell the river what to do. So now, Baruch Hashem, we have the Torah today. With the zichud of the Torah, we can change things. But my friend, don't forget, the more you are tzaddik, the more you want to be close to Hashem, the tzara is very big. So never lay down your protection, the Torah. The Torah said, Vayishiv Yisrael Vashitim. This Shlumiel ben Tzuri Shaddai was a big tzaddik. But it's the Torah said, Vayishiv Yisrael Vashitim. They started to see to relax. When you relax with no Torah, you lose your powerful. You lose your koah. You lose everything. That is the message. The Torah wants to teach us, look, this man, Shlumiel ben Tzuri Shaddai, how tzaddik he was. How big man he was. He was among those people who did the inauguration of the Mishkan. And he was a prophet. He was a kadosh. He was a kadosh. He was like a malach. And because he stopped from learning Torah, look what happened to him. He went out with a goya. Al ta'amid be'atzmach adyumotah. Never think you are strong. You are perfect. Perfect. Till you die. As long as you are alive, the Tzara can hold you in your hand and his hand. And this is the message of what the Torah wants to teach us. What the Torah wants to teach us? The Torah, she wants to teach us how much we have to be strong. And the strength came only against the Tzara when you study Torah. You take from your time for HaKadosh Baruch Hu. This is, the Torah was not given only to the rabbis. The Torah was given to everybody. Today, Baruch Hashem, we see a lot of people. They work all day, business all day, and they have dafayumi. Baruch Hashem, I'm jealous of one that he did 3 times the Siyum of Hashas. He's a businessman. He lives in New York. I'm jealous of him. It's not a jealousy. I say, why I don't do like him? Why? And he comes. Every time I'm here, he comes to get bracha. And last week he came, when he came to my office, he told me, I'm sorry that I came 1 minute late because I was finishing my daf ayumi. I mean, today, Baruch Hashem, even by telephone, you can hear daf ayumi. And it's the third time that he finished the shas. The third time. I'm jealous. Bemet, I am. But I don't know. So I was looking at him and I hold him, I kiss him. I tell him, I'm not your rabbi, you are my rabbi. I never finish a shas once. You finish 3 times. You have a big schut. Rabotai, this is the message of the parasha Naso. Naso from the word elevation. Naso. Be'alotekha, the parasha of this week is from the word Be'alotekha. You have to go from step to step. בעזרת השם שהקדוש ברוך הוא יביאו ברכה והצלחה, בריאות, פרנסה טובה, עלייה בתורה, בריאת שמיים, אמן כרצון.